Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying, only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare.
This is Kugan Cassius, right from London. We're at the Only Fools and Horses Convention here in Peterborough 2013. With me, who played Jevon, Steven Woodcock. How are you, sir?
I'm good.
Is this your first year here, sir?
It is, yes.
What are you making from it? Obviously, there's a massive crowd out there, all wanting your autograph and pictures signed. What are you making of it all?
It's a good day so far. You know, been an early start, but yeah, it is a good one.
How much of a bad influence was you on Rodney?
I'm not sure which one of us was worse. I think in the end he got the upper hand, but I was quite an influence, I think, yeah.
And out of all the episodes you've done, what one springs to mind? Maybe the bet you had with Rodney on the dance floor where he sort of had the cards already stacked, where he'd already met Cassandra,
yeah,
but you didn't know
right.
that.
No, I didn't know that, yeah. Well, Jevon didn't know that rather than Steven Woodcock. But that's probably, you know, a very memorable episode for me. I mean, Jolly Boy's outing obviously was good. Dates, I think, was good for everyone, just as the whole shows. I never really just look at something just because I'm in it. So I do sort of like sort of all the episodes, really. But without a doubt, you know, Jolly Boy's outing was a very good one. And the one that you were just speaking about with, you know, She's a Lesbian.
I mean, yeah, it is. Sorry. I think he was secretly trying to get a picture of me then, was you, Steve?
You never know.
What sort of response do you get? Do you still obviously get people mobbing you in the streets and things?
Every day for Only Fools and Horses, yeah. It's a non-stop thing. I mean, it's just such a big programme. It's got such a cult following at the moment. I wouldn't even say questionable whether it's the best comedy series ever done. I think it is. And as we can see from today, you know, the amount of people that you get at these conventions actually sort of kind of confirms that, really. I don't think any other comedy series that BBC's ever done has actually carried the same amount of following as Only Fools and Horses. And it's great to have done it, and it is great to be here today. Yeah.
Can you tell the people what you've been up to recently, obviously, since Only Fools and Horses has been taken off screen?
Yeah, I spend a lot of my time writing now. I'm a singer-songwriter, so I do. I'm out gigging quite a bit at the moment, and I've also been working on sort of the odd TV program, actually literally writing them, really, and sort of into developing some projects of my own as a writer. But it's mainly at the moment I'm out with a guitar in my hand as a singer-songwriter, and that's mainly what's been keeping me going these days.
Sounds like you've got lots going on. Right, well, listen, we're not going to take too much of your time. Thank you very much for talking to iFILM London. And it's going to be a long day for you.
Great one, yeah. Well, great to everyone out there. Hope you still carry on enjoying Only Fools and it goes on for many more years.
Kugan Cassius here with Steven Woodcock for iFILM London. Thank you very much.
Everybody's talking at me. I don't hear words they're saying. Only the echoes of my mind. People stop and stare.